animation is a form of cinema that has impacted me since I was a kid. These are the films that raised me, the characters that I grew up with. But why does animation impact us so much? What makes animation so believable and engaging? What makes it so real? We can clearly see how animation has grown over the years. Just look at the difference between Woody and Bo Peep in Toy Story 1 and Toy Story 4. As technology continues to advance, animation studios mimic more live-action film techniques. With animation, there are endless possibilities to creating a whole new world and unique characters. Realism is necessary in animation to allow audiences to accept and engage with all types of characters and environments. As a disclaimer, I will be using mostly Pixar examples, which are influenced by a more Western view of realism. Anime tends to approach realism in a whole new way, but I will briefly touch on that later in the video. Mimesis. The purpose of mimesis in animation is to replicate reality. Mimesis is the representation or imitation of the real world in art and literature. Animation mimics techniques in live-action films. Camera movements. Even though there aren't real cameras in animated films, the simulated camera movements create a sense of depth and space. Let's look at this scene in Soul. The handheld camera movement amongst the hectic city life creates a stressful, anxious feeling. This shows what's going on inside Joe Gardner's head. We can also look at the film Inside Out. Inside Riley's head, the camera movements are smooth and fluid. They feel whimsical and peaceful. This contrasts with the cameras in Riley's reality, which are shaky, showing her anxiety. These feel more raw and realistic compared to the fantastical world inside her head.
We were worried sick. Where have you been? It's so late.
Lighting. Animation also replicates the lighting seen in live-action films. Lighting has come a long way in animated films. The attention to detail with lighting helps the film feel more realistic. The filmmakers use the lighting to help shape the story and create the tone and feeling of a scene. Lighting can make a character feel intimidating. It can make a scene feel more tender and emotional. Lighting makes an animated film truly come to life. Facial expressions. Facial expressions on animated characters are essential for telling an effective story. To do this, the facial expressions of humans are mimicked. Let's look at Finding Dory. Fish don't actually have eyebrows. But animators chose to give the characters in the film eyebrows, so their expressions are more impactful.
They're dead?
In Cars, animators were able to give cars emotion while staying true to the look of a real car.
Oh, yes.
The same goes for Walle-E, where Walle-E and Eve can show different emotions by the way their eyes mimic human facial expressions. This makes us feel more connected and impacted by the characters. Movement. Realistic movement and gravity is essential to make characters feel tactile. The way a character moves and interacts with their environment has to mimic how it would look in real life to feel believable. In Piper, we can feel how small and light Piper is because of how she runs in the sand. And when she is underwater, we can feel the weightlessness of the shells and how the water pulls away. In this Pixar short, Lou is made out of lost and found objects, but the way his motion is animated mimics the movement of animals. This makes his movement feel more believable since we can relate it to something real. Poesis. Animation doesn't use realism solely for the purpose of replicating reality. Using realism can be used to create something new. It can create a whole new world that is believable to the audience. Poesis is the activity in which a person brings something into being that does not exist before. Let's discuss immersive realism. This is a type of realism that creates a bridge between reality and fantasy. Creating a whole new world is a difficult task, but by using elements of realism, the animators can take fantastical elements and ideas and make them feel believable. Immersive realism takes the rules of a familiar world and bends them in a way only possible through animation. Luca creates a whole new world with new creatures and environments. In this scene, the community looks like something we would see in reality, except it's underwater and full of sea monsters. But the attention to detail with the expansive world makes it feel real. Now let's look at anime. Anime films have a different perspective on realism. They aren't necessarily three-dimensional like Pixar films, but they are highly imaginative and pay close attention to detail in a way that makes them feel immersive. They represent reality in different ways while still drawing us in and creating a balance between reality and fantasy. In Spirited Away, a fantastical world is created, but there are still elements of realism that build the world. Everything is specifically thought out in detail. The environment has its own rules, but the familiar elements of reality make it feel real, thus making it possible to create this whole new world. Another type of realism is uncanny realism. This uses realistic elements to create a feeling of unfamiliarity and uneasiness. By taking our expectations of reality and twisting them, the scene feels believable but slightly off. In the scene in Paprika, objects in the parade are moving in a fluid-like way that looks realistic, but obviously wouldn't be possible in reality. This makes the scene feel uncanny, but overall helps tell the story. It uses characteristics of realism, but in a whole new way. Overall, it is clear that elements of realism are intentionally placed in animation. This does not mean that the stories have to be realistic, but it helps the audience believe in the story. Emotions and feelings are better translated, and characters are easier to connect with.
I miss my family.
Family.
Realism makes the world of animation more believable, engaging, and impactful.
When life gets you down, you know what you gotta do?
I don't wanna know what you gotta do.
Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming.
You made it! No! Go save Riley!
Take her to the moon for me. Okay.
Jerry. Gerolamo. Trombetta.
Seriously, what does that mean?
No idea. Go find out for me, will ya?